welcome to episode 26 of China Tools. My name is Dennis and I am from Hooked on Wood. In this episode, it is all about T-tracks, flip stops, and which clamp is best for your workbench, drill press platform, or crosscut sled. And one of you can be the one who makes the first cut in this kick-ass crosscut sled that I will give away. And if you want to know how you can make a chance of winning this crosscut sled, keep watching till the end of the video. This China Tool video is different. I will not rate the products as I normally do. They are all good enough, and if not, I tell you. And I will tell you my favorites. And they sell many more products than I can show in this video. So I just want to inform you where you have to look for when you are interested in these kind of products. Because of the change in regulations for Europe, prices changes on Banggood. Prices included VAT now, so Banggood will declare and pay VAT. For outside Europe, nothing changed. But I'm happy to see that although the prices include VAT now, it's very interesting to buy at Banggood. At the release of this video, they have a 7-7 sales event, which is a big thing. So if you're interested in these products, prices are very attractive at this moment, and that counts for all the products they sell, of course. And of course, I would appreciate it if you would use one of my links. It does not cost you anything extras, but you support my channel. Thank you. All these products are sent to me by Banggood, so there are definitely more T-tracks in the market. But the nice thing of Banggood is that they have a lot of T-tracks and accessories to make something nice and interesting for your workshop. And I will continue this video with a voiceover, but I already want to thank you for watching. In general, Banggood offers three different kinds of T-tracks. A small T-track, a bigger miter track, and a miter track with scale. I want to start with this bigger T-track or miter track. It is comparable in dimensions with the T-slot in most table saws. And if you want to use a miter track on your router table, this is the size you need. To test these products, I made an additional top for my workbench to include these T-tracks. And these are the most versatile T-tracks because you can use them with almost all the accessories. You can use different clamps on these miter tracks, but if you use them on a router table, you can also attach featherboards. And I recently got this lovely router fence that also needs a T-track like this. To place these T-tracks, you have to cut a groove with your router. And Festool has a railguide adapter which makes it very easy to fit these T-tracks perfectly. But of course there are other options to get this done. And if you want to know how, I could make a video for my Instagram about this, so let me know in the comments if that is interesting. You have to screw these T-tracks in place, and because they are around 30 mm deep, 80 mm thick material is too thin. So you should place two sheets of 80 mm on each other. And if you want to use these miter tracks with clamps, they should be connected firmly to a material like plywood, for example. When two miter tracks have to cross each other, there are two options. A solution with four small bars and a solution with one small bar that has an opening for the cross section. And I wanted to test them both to see if one solution works smoother than the other. And I have to say that there is not a difference when you have to use them. If I put my miter gauge through it, it goes smoothly through both of the cross sections, so both work very well. I placed a blue miter track on my table saw, and it's a shame that the color is slightly different. Also, there's a difference in color between the cross sections and T-tracks, and when you place them, you can see these differences a bit. With the red color, this is also the same, but less noticeable. The gray color seems to be the most uniform. But I like the different colors because they can give a personal touch. I like the red and blue color on birch plywood, for example. And I also like the dark gray on the black MDF. But this dark gray T-track is slightly different in measurement. And therefore, it does not work with the aluminum sliding nuts. And you cannot tighten them down. It works on these blue sliders, but you cannot buy these separately. So, this is a shame. And because of this, I would not advise this T-track. Or you should make the slider nut a bit thinner at the above side. The rest from the colors I tested works perfectly. You can buy these T-tracks in different lengths. And when you can use a specific length, both sides are finished in the same color as the T-track and the holes of the screws are placed perfectly over its length. But you can also buy a longer length and cut them yourself. but if you do so, you end up with an aluminum collar at the beginning or end of the T-track. And you have to drill some holes for the screws yourself. We also have these smaller T-tracks. And I have to say that I thought in the beginning that a rail guide clamp would fit in these clamps, but that is not the case. Some clamps fit in these T-tracks. And you can also buy some screws that fit in these T-tracks as well. And with these screws you can attach everything you like. The advantage of this smaller T-track is their size, and therefore you can use them perfectly on a crosscut sled, for example. And at last we have these combination T-tracks, and this is practically a T-track with a place to add a ruler. And besides the different colors, you can buy them with or without a scale. And the ones with an included ruler are good to read, but I would advise buying a ruler separately to add to this T-track. The ruler on the T-track itself is not that bad, but in general the contrast of a ruler you add yourself is better. You have more flexibility, and depending on the flip stop you use, one is simply better to read than another. And I have a few different kinds of rulers, and you can buy almost all these rulers with different scales, counting to the right or to the left, but also starting from the middle. And then you have different style of rulers, like traditional ones or fancier with aluminum. I like the traditional one on the red, for example. The traditional one is still the best to read. And with some flip stops, like the red one, you'll see a tiny needle. And this is better to read on a white background than on a red or a gray background. This ruler looks the same as the fixed ruler on this gray T-track, but you see the numbers are bigger and better to read. And that is why I think there's always an advantage to buy a separate ruler that fits your style and flip stop best. And depending on the flipstop you use, it's better to choose one design over the other. With this red flipstop you see this very tiny needle, and in this case it's best to choose a ruler with the marks at the sides. If you look at this blue flipstop, it has a bigger needle, and therefore it's best to choose a ruler with the lines in the middle. Otherwise you cannot accurately read the scale. And that same counts for these black flipstops. They also have a bigger needle, and are better to set up accurately with the marks in the middle. I just want to show you a bit of the making of this video. To get a good feeling of these products, I decided to make platforms and fences to discover the possibilities and the limitations of these products. So I made a new tabletop, three fences, a drill press platform, and a nice crosscut sled. And because of that, producing a video like this cost around 60 to 80 hours. And that is not a problem, because I enjoy doing it. My average video cost me about 30 to 50 hours to produce. So if you like my approach, please subscribe to my channel. I would appreciate it very much. And for all those loyal watchers and users of my links, thank you for all your support. I have some different clamps you can all use on these miter tracks. And first I want to show you this big clamp. It is the most expensive clamp, and you immediately see why. It is bigger, it has a very high quality fit and finish, and it comes in a very nice box. It also includes some extras. It has the most extensive reach of all the clamps I have, and it also has a pretty high clamping force. Without too much pressure you can clamp around 60 kg. And for the use on a drill press platform, I find them too big. But if clamping force and a big capacity are what you're looking for, these clamps deliver on both of these aspects. The second one is this black one. It has a back foot that you can change in height. And this one has 3 levels, but you can also get them with 5 levels. The advantage is by changing the level, you have a longer reach. And the reach is almost the same as with the former clamp. And you have to get used to it a little bit, but I tend to like this solution over that of the former clamp. And because of this mechanism, the clamp is not that big, but has a good reach. And because of its smaller size, it is better usable on the drill press platform. Its clamping force is very good. 100 kg of pressure is suitable to handle with this clamp. And if you want to use this force, you have to make sure your T-tracks are screwed strong and with enough body to the tabletop. I like the build quality and material use. And this would be one of my favorites as a clamp for your workbench top because it has a good reach and enough clamping force. If you compare this with how much pressure I can give with my rail guide clamps combined with my dog holes, they end at 50 kg. So these clamps can provide some real pressure. This clamp comes as a single piece or as a set of two, and then it is very attractive from a price point of view. It is nicely finished and they are very small. And although small, they can still clamp pieces of 55 mm. They also have this white plastic ring that holds the spring. But this gets skewed if the bar is not straight to the ring, and then it becomes difficult to tighten. And I think it is best suitable for hold down pieces to 36 mm. Then it works best. And because of its size, it's very nice to work with on a drill press platform or a crosscut sled. It also comes delivered with a small dog hole, so you can also use it with dog holes. But the dog hole should be reachable from the underside of the table. Although small, you can give pretty much pressure with this clamp. 60 kg is definitely possible. The last clamp I want to mention is my favorite. And when you buy it as a set, it is very attractive from a price point of view. It has a straightforward design, and because it does not have a spring, it works the fastest. You can tighten the screw very easily and then tighten the workpiece. Its reach is about 55 mm, but it handles this with ease. Its clamping force is a bit limited. It's easier to get more force with other clamps. But 35 kg of pressure seems enough for me to hold down most of the workpieces. Also, on my drill press platform, I think this one is the best choice in combination with the former clamp. It also comes delivered with another screw that you can use in the smaller T-tracks. I like its simplicity, and because of the smaller screw, it also has the flexibility to use it in different places. Another accessory you can use with these T-tracks are these sliders and flip-stops. And if you want to make a drill press platform or a crosscut sled, these products are very useful. Let us look at these MiloTrack stoppers. And you can use them to connect a fence, and then you can slide your fence in these MiloTracks. And here I made a fence myself with these sliders. I connected them at the back in a MiloTrack. These MiloTrack stoppers come with or without an adjustable needle to better read a ruler. And they come with these small screws at the back, and you cannot use these in these MiloTracks. They also do not fit in the smaller T-tracks. They are meant to use with a fence in which they will fit. So to use these in the MiloTrack, you need some of these sliders. And you can buy them separately. And when you want to use T-tracks, I would advise to buy a few of them because they become very handy and are not that expensive. When you have to drill a hole at the edge of a piece of wood, the fence can come in its way. However, I use this in combination with different flip stops, and I really like this combination. If you used to drill holes on the edge of a piece of wood pretty often, I would consider other options or cut a V-shape in the fence so the drill press chuck can go lower. Otherwise, it's very nice to work this way. My drill press has a laser pointer, making it very easy to line up a piece of wood. I do not need a scale or ruler to set up my drill press. It's easier to mark where you want to drill a hole and use the laser. And when you have set up your fence and flip stops, it's so enjoyable to make small production work. It's very accurate and easy. If you look at the flip stops, I have some different models. And if you want to use them on a drill press, these smaller ones are very nice. I have tested all the flip stops on accuracy and they all perform very well. Also, all the flip stops are sturdy enough to stay in place when you push something against them. And like I said, on a drill press I like the smaller ones. The blue ones come with or without a needle. It is a price attractive flip stop, but the fit and finish of the needle is a bit disappointing. It is cut with a laser and it does not look that nice. It has sharp edges and burrs. Further than that, it looks nice and I like the handle nut to tighten it. These red flip stops are also small and I like them for a drill press. They have a higher finish and a needle cut from aluminum, and this looks nice and is easy to adjust. But the needle is very small and more difficult to read. I would use it with a traditional ruler with lines on the side. And I find them very attractive from a price point of view, considering its fit and finish. The only thing I do not like that much is the handle to tighten it. I found the handle nut much more practical. Last miter track stop with needles are these black flip stops. They look bulkier, but I still like to use them on my drill press. They give me the best feeling from a quality point of view. And I like the appearance and the combination with the golden looking knobs. Another advantage is that you can easily cut these arms shorter. So this way you can use them on a flat fence. I also like these flip stops in combination with a crosscut sled. They are big enough to hold a piece of wood even if you put it too hard against the arm. The needle is good to read and good to adjust. This is my personal favorite and I like this one for both my drill press as my crosscut sled. And I believe that they sell for less than $13 during the 7/7 sales event. That is a ridiculous low price for this miter stop. Further, I also test some flip stops without needles. And I have to say that I do not prefer one over the other. They all work the same and they all work fine. I tend to like this hand button nut to tighten it. It's easier to handle. They are very usable on a drill press. And on a crosscut sled, I would prefer a flip stop with a needle. But if you do not need that, then they are also suitable for that. The last thing what I want to mention are these screws with handle nuts. If you are going to use these miter tracks and T-tracks, I would also get a few of these because they become very handy when you want to make something yourself. And I also would advise a set of these sliders with them. I made a fence for my drill press with these screws and I used the side to slide the fence back and forth, and when I tighten the handle nut, my fence will always be aligned at the exact distance from the drill bit. And this makes working with a scale very accurate and repeatable. By holding the fence low, I have no problem if I have to drill a hole close to the edge because the chuck of my drill press will not touch my fence. And I really like the fence I made and I think I will fine tune this design, which will probably end up on my drill press platform. Well, we came to the end of this video. I hope I give you some insight into the different items I got from Banggood. And to test them, I had to make some things, making this a more time intensive video. The crosscut sled is a piece I will not use because I have a fence on my table saw, and in my new workshop I will get a format saw. So I decided to give it away. And I did not mount it together, so you can adjust it to your own table saw. The sliders are screwed at the bottom and only glued at four small dots, so you can easily remove it. I don't think it's the best crosscut sled because all the MDF makes it a bit more heavier than I would prefer, but it looks awesome. And you could say it is very stable. So if you want to make a chance of winning this kick-ass crosscut sled with clamps, etc., you have of course subscribed to my channel, but also subscribe to my Instagram account and let me know on Instagram why you want it. I will pick a winner at the end of this month from these reactions. And this sounds a bit complicated, so sorry for that. But I spent a lot of time to make this crosscut set beautiful, so I hope it's worth the extra effort it takes to make a chance of winning it. And my Instagram account is also very nice to follow. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it interesting. I could tell much more about these products because I spend a lot of time with them. So maybe I add some extra information in another video. I want to thank you for watching. Stay safe. and we will see each other next time.